sir, for giving me this opportunity. It's a great pleasure and honor to come and talk to you, especially on the background that the Indian Renaissance Trust was founded by M.N. Roy, the legendary M.N. Roy. And I think he was a man who was way ahead of his time as far as his thinking is concerned. And when I started revisiting his biography and his thought as a preparation for what I'm going to talk to you today, what I started realizing is that there are very great similarities between the way M.N. Roy conceptualized rationality and my father and the leader of Maharashtra Andhrashraddha Nirmulan Samiti, Narendra Dabholkar, conceptualized rationality. And that was a kind of a revelation for me. So I went back and talked to my mom about that, and what she told me actually surprised me, that in his early days, Dr. Dabholkar was fascinated by ideology of M.N. Roy. And what is very interesting, the book today I am carrying, the first of his writing, which is available now in English, is translated by Suman Oak, who was a famous noted Royist from Maharashtra. Sadly, she passed away a month back, but I think this is very valuable contribution from a Royist to Maharashtra Andhrashraddha Nirmulan Samiti, and I will like to remember her contribution fondly before I begin. The reason I said he was influenced by, my father was influenced by M.N. Roy, the simile starts actually with the name of the magnum opus that they have written. So the name of this book, which summarizes work of Maharashtra Andhrashraddha Nirmulan Samiti for 25 years, is The Case for Reason, Part 1 and Part 2. And the magnum opus of M.N. Roy, as all of us know, is also in two parts, and it starts again with the reason, romanticism and revolution. So it's pretty clear the rationality or reason is the central, if we want to try and distill out the essence of what M.N. Roy stood for, or what not Narendra Dabholkar stood for, I think it can be summarized in one word, reason or rationality. And that's again the reason why all of us are together here in this group. So it's really an honor to be on this stage with you all, which is named after him. And it can't be a more appropriate timing than this for all of us to be together, because the challenges that we are facing, not only in Maharashtra, not only nationally, but internationally also, and the single most, I think, the important challenge, if we want to crystallize the between the number of challenges that we have across the globe as well as locally, is the spread of irrationality. And irrationality started getting organized, and I will try and explain you why I think so. In locally, it starts with a very personal example, which is actually not personal but very national and global, is the brutal assassination of Dr. Narendra Dabholkar, and then the three assassinations that followed, Comrade Pansare, Gauri Lankesh and M.M. Kalburgi. Nobody would have thought in an independent India, somebody who is just trying to spread rationalist thought will meet such an end. Sadly, we would have thought that, okay, ye Pakistan mein hota hai, ye Bangladesh mein hota hai, but not in my country, not in my state, not in Maharashtra. But sadly, we have witnessed that time where people are gunned down, not 1, 2, 3, 4, just for the reason that they are spreading awareness in society. And see the progress that these irrational forces have done in our country, when the murderers came for Jyotiba Phule, whose legacy and Savitribai Phule, whose legacy we all believe into. Dr. Dabholkar used to talk about him as the vice chancellor of the University of Rationality. He used to refer to him as a vice chancellor of the University of Rationality. When murderers came for Jyotiba Phule and they realized the guy they were going to murder was Jyotiba Phule, who was working for peasants and gender equality and upliftment of women, they dropped the plan of killing Jyotiba Phule and became his students. So this was 150 years back. 50 years back, when they came for Mahatma Gandhi, they at least have had this daring to shoot him from the front and declare who they were. But when they came for Narendra Dabholkar 50 years after that, they came and shoot him from the backside. They didn't even bother to declare who they were. When they came for Comrade Pansare, they didn't even spare his wife Umatai. And when they went for Gauri and Kalburgi sir, they even didn't bother to enter their home and kill them. So it can't be a more challenging time where the biggest threat any human being can perceive is the threat of his or her life. And that's the biggest threat that we are perceiving as a rationalist community, not as MANS worker, but as a rationalist community. Because what I believe, though the bullets were fired at Dr. Dabholkar and Comrade Pansare, Kalburgi and Gauri Lankesh, the signal was given to all of us.
Yes.
See what we can do to you. If you speak one word, then this is the fate that you are going to end up with. So that's the era we are living into. And on the national scene, if we start observing, it's very difficult to figure out who is talking sense. Because there are people who have started claiming in an organized manner that electricity was available from the time of Ramayana. Narad was the first
journalist,
and Google was available from the ancient times, and E is equal to MC square was actually discovered before Einstein by somebody from the Vedas. So this has now reached to a level where we have also stopped actually counting them and retaliating them. So in a way, it has started becoming like a new narrative which is now established. So they can talk about it and just get away by talking so. But if we start thinking that this is only a national problem, let me share with you a couple of examples which in last month I have observed, not only nationally but globally. And this is not only last month, this is a trend which is going on internationally also for many years now. I will just refer to 3 or 4 incidences which have happened in different parts of world. Very funny incidents which was reported by Indian Express. In Russia, which all of us know now for almost 2 decades is under the control of Putin Raj. So a shaman, a mystic from Siberia declares that Putin is not bad guy. He is actually possessed by some bad powers, and that shaman declares that he is now going to take a walk from Siberia to Moscow, and on the lines he was going to make people aware that Putin is not bad, he is actually possessed by some evil powers, and I am going to get him free of those powers. This is like a black comedy Hindi movie or English movie script. Subconsciously also you can't talk the truth, so and as one can understand, that guy ended up in a mental asylum, picked up by Putin's people. And but comprehending this phenomena is not very straightforward. 3 weeks back, all of us know that a lady from Kerala was coronated as saint in the Vatican City, who has passed away at least three decades back, and the reason she was coronated as a saint is based on a claim that she saved a baby in ICU in Kerala in 2008, when actually she was no more. So, and then there is a medical practitioner who has actually witnessed on her behalf, saying that this condition was not medically cured, and this was a miracle performed by a lady who is no more on this earth for last three decades, and Vatican bestows her sainthood. So if we are thinking that it's our national problem, I think we are wrong. And yesterday's Indian Express again tells a very interesting story about the Prince of Japan, who is now going to reach to the become the king, and there is a ceremony in Japan where that prince spends one night with the goddess of sun. I don't know what that means. And the expenses are incurred by the Japanese state. And now they have a debate going on whether a secular state can sponsor such ceremony. So if we are thinking this problem of irrationality is restricted only to Maharashtra or India, then I think we are wrong. The irrationality is like Emin Roy said, on the other side, as on one side he said that freedom is the basic basic survival instinct of human beings. Sometimes jocularly I feel irrationality is also a basic survival instinct inbuilt in the human brain. And the reason I am trying to discuss these things or put these things on the table, just to help us to comprehend the kind of a problem that all of us are facing, or the issue that we have taken up as our life mission, how complicated it can turn in. What my father used to say in Marathi, I will first tell you and then try and translate it in English. What he used to say ke, in Hindi, ke, jis kshetr mein main kaam karta hoon, us kshetr ki jo ladai hai, wo ek saal ki nahi, kuch saalon ki nahi, kuch dashkon ki nahi, to kuch centuries ki ladai hai. To ye mujhe lagta hai ke hamare liye pata rakhna bahut zaruri hai ke jo ladai hum lad rahe hain wo kuch saalon ki nahi hai, kuch decades ki nahi hai, कुछ शतकों की लड़ाई है. क्योंकि ऐसा थॉट जब से दुनिया में आया है, उसका इतिहास और ऑर्गेनाइज रिलीजन का इतिहास, इसमें वर्षों के हिसाब में आप देखें तो बहुत बड़ा अंतर है. तो ये मुझे लगता है कि बहुत ध्यान में रखना जरूरी है. मैं महाराष्ट्र अंधश्रद्धा निर्मूलन समिति के काम के बारे में पूरा नहीं बताऊंगा. शायद मेरे कलीग हैं मिलिंद अनीस के ट्रस्टी है गिरमे सर, वो भी कंट्रीब्यूट कर सकते हैं बाद में जब हम डिस्कस करेंगे. लेकिन मैं चार या पांच प्रिंसिपल्स पे बात करना चाहता हूं कि जो डॉक्टर नरेंद्र दाभोलकर की हत्या को अभी इस 20 अगस्त को 6 साल पूरे हुए, तो इस 6 साल में जो ऑर्गेनाइज काम हम सब लोगों ने किया और उस पे द एक्सपीरियंस दैट वी गैदर्ड थ्रू ऑल दिस वर्क इन लास्ट 6 years, आई जस्ट ट्राई एंड समराइज दैट इनटू 5 or 6 बुलेट पॉइंट्स, व्हिच आई थिंक इज वेरी कैन बी अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेसन्स फॉर द रैशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट, नॉट इन महाराष्ट्र बट अदरवाइज ऑल्सो. एंड द फर्स्ट लेसन आई थिंक दैट वी हैव लर्न एंड वी स्टूड बाई इट वेरी फर्म ऑन आवर ग्राउंड is that the battle for rationality cannot be fought by irrational means. So, like sir said, that if somebody said something bad to you on Facebook, and now that's not an expression of anger, it's an organized syndicate, you know. And if you retaliate to them with the same language, then that's, you can't claim that you are rational. In the same way, if somebody killed Dr. Narendra Dabholkar, then taking law in your hand and retaliating through unconstitutional means is in itself defeating what he stood for. So we were very clear right from the beginning of his murder that whatever fight we are going to undertake has to follow the principles for which he stood for. And you won't believe that there was not a single incidence of violence in Maharashtra, which sometimes you might feel that this is a bit of an exaggeration, but even after murder of Mahatma Gandhi or Indira Gandhi, which this country couldn't achieve, MANS and the like-minded progressive people of Maharashtra, they managed to do it after the murder of Dr. Dabholkar and Comrade Pansare, because they believed into the value they stood for. Not a single incidence of violence. See, for an organization of a size of MANS and with the support of other organizations, it's not very difficult to throw a stone here and there and to burn a bus here and there. But this was the commitment, and we stood with the commitment for last 6 years. Then what we did? Then did we kept silent? तो हम चुप भी नहीं बैठे. तो जो जो constitutional means है, वो सब हमने इस्तेमाल किए. क्या क्या होते हैं constitutional means? तो हमने high court में writ petition किया कि investigation ठीक से नहीं हो रहा है. गए 6 साल में उसके 40 से भी ज़्यादा hearing हुए हैं. High court monitoring कर रहा है case. तो हर एक hearing के साथ थोड़ा थोड़ा आगे बढ़ता है. हमने हर महीने के 20 तारीख को यही वो ब्रिज है, विट्ठल रामजी शिंदे ब्रिज, वो ब्रिज बीच पे हर महीने के 20 तारीख को, जिस तारीख को डॉक्टर नरेंद्र दाभोलकर को मारा गया था 20 अगस्त को, हर महीने के 20 तारीख को हम वहां जाते थे. 5 लोग हो, 50 लोग हो या 100 लोग हो, हम वहां खड़े रहते थे और एक ही सवाल पूछते थे कि डॉक्टर दाभोलकर के हत्यारों को कब पकड़ा जाएगा. विदाउट अ फेल 60 times एवरी मंथ वी गैदर्ड देयर एंड वी आस्क जस्ट वन क्वेश्चन के ये आप कब पकड़ने वाले हो. और मीडिया से हमने बात की, मीडिया ने बहुत सपोर्ट किया इस कॉज को, क्योंकि उन्हें भी लगता था कि ये इम्पोर्टेंट कॉज है, इसके बारे में बात होनी चाहिए. एंड इन डेमोक्रेसी मीडिया इज अ वेरी लेजिटिमेट एंड वैलिड टूल दैट यू कैन यूज टू आस्क व्हेन देन यू आर आस्किंग फॉर जस्टिस. और हमने अपना काम चालू रखा. तो मुझे लगता है कि ये जो चीज़ें हैं कि रैशनैलिटी के बारे में हम बोलते हैं, तो हमारे मींस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल होने चाहिए. ये मुझे लगता है कि बहुत बड़ी और अहम बात है. ऐसे हमारे ज़िंदगी में ऐसे दोराहे आते हैं, ऐसे कठिन प्रसंग आते हैं कि जब ऐसे लगता है कि कुछ नहीं हो सकता. ये इन्वेस्टिगेशन, यानी मैं इन्वेस्टिगेशन के हिसाब से बात कर रहा हूँ तो उसका रेफरेंस देता हूँ कि वी हैव रीच्ड अ डेड एंड, इसके आगे कुछ नहीं हो सकता. देर वेर पीपल अराउंड अस हु वेर रिपीटेडली आस्किंग अस के आप कुछ तो ऐसे धमाकेदार कीजिए जिससे लोगों का ध्यान बटा जाए. ऑब्वियसली दे मेंट दैट यू टेक द लॉ इन योर हैंड, बट वी डिडंट डू एनी ऑफ दैट थिंग. एंड आई थिंक दिस वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग एज फार एज द रैशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट इज कंसर्न. तो कितना भी तकलीफ हो, कितना भी प्रॉब्लम हो, एक बार हमने जो तय किया है कि हमारे जो प्रॉब्लम्स है हम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल मीन से ही सॉल्व करेंगे, तो वो छोड़ना नहीं चाहिए. ये मुझे लगता है बहुत बड़ा लेसन है, और उससे आज नहीं तो कल न्याय मिलेगा. मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ कि अवर कंट्री has a legacy of a battle, a non-violent battle for more than 150 years. जब हमारा constitution भी नहीं था तब भी हमने non-violent battle किया है. तो मुझे लगता है कि आज तो
हमारे लोग ही है जिनको हमने चुन के दिया है. वी हैव मेनी मोर डेमोक्रेटिक मीन्स टू द एंड एंड दिस इज वन इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू मैंशन. द सेकेंड इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग, डॉक्टर दाभोलकर वॉज किल्ड फॉर द वर्क दैट ही स्टूड फॉर. इट वॉज नॉट, ये कोई प्रॉपर्टी का डिस्प्यूट नहीं था या कोई पर्सनल एनिमिटी नहीं थी. अभी ये मैं नहीं बोल रहा, सीबीआई उनके चार्जशीट में बोल रहा है कि ये पर्सनल एनिमिटी नहीं थी. जो काम डॉक्टर नरेंद्र दाभोलकर कर रहे थे उसे खत्म करने के लिए ये ऑर्गेनाइज्ड साजिश की गई थी. ये अभी मैं नहीं बोलता, ये सीबीआई बोलता है, एसआईटी बोलती है, सभी बोलते हैं. तो वो काम चालू रखना, वो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत बड़ी प्राधान्य का विषय था हमारे लिए. इट वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस एंड with lot of pride I can share this with you that not a single program of MANS after assassination of Dr. Narendra Dabholkar was cancelled and not a single activist stopped his work due to the fear that he also might be targeted. So mujhe lagta hai ki jaise hamara Maharashtra Andhashraddha Nirmulan Samiti ka ek trisutri hai jisme एक होता है विज्ञान, दूसरा होता है नीति, तो साइंस एंड मॉरेलिटी, लेकिन उसके बीच में जो होता है वो निर्भयता, सो करेजियसनेस. और वो निर्भयता जिनको आई थिंक रैशनैलिटी के पाथ पे चलना है, द पीपल हु वांट टू वर्क इन द फील्ड ऑफ रैशनैलिटी, दे जस्ट कांट बाईपास दिस मिडिल निर्भयता. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो बहुत ही अहम है और उसके साथ अपना काम चालू रखना. तो महाराष्ट्र में गए 6 साल में 2 सोशली प्रोग्रेसिव लेजिग्नेशन पास हुए, एक एंटी ब्लैक मैजिक एक्ट था, दूसरा सोशल बॉयकॉट के खिलाफ एक्ट था. महाराष्ट्र पहला राज्य है भारत में कि जहां ऐसा इतना कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव एक्ट दोनों पास हुए हैं. सिर्फ एक्ट पास करके ये काम नहीं रुका, 500 से भी ज़्यादा केसेस एंटी ब्लैक मैजिक एक्ट के अंतर्गत फाइल किए गए हैं. और सबसे अहम बात यह है कि ये 500 केसेस MANS के वर्कर्स ने नहीं किए, इसमें से 50% से भी ज्यादा केसेस है जो आम लोगों ने किए हैं. तो मुझे लगता है वो बहुत अहम बात है कि आम लोग ये जो लॉ है उसका इस्तेमाल कर रहे हैं. एंटी सोशल बॉयकॉट के खिलाफ जो लॉ है वो भी मुझे लगता है कि पंजाब और हरियाणा में आप सोच भी नहीं सकते कि खाप पंचायत के सामने कोई बात कर सके. लेकिन यू वोंट बिलीव विद द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एफर्ट्स ऑफ MANS इन महाराष्ट्र, देयर वेर 12 खाप पंचायत, व्हाट वी कॉल देम एज अ जाप पंचायत हियर, वेर एक्चुअली एबॉलिश्ड विदाउट टेकिंग हेल्प ऑफ लॉ, जस्ट बाय डेमोक्रेटिक डायलॉग. सो द पॉइंट आई वॉन्ट टू मेक इज वी परसिस्टेड विद आवर वर्क. Now there are 3 or 4 major campaigns of MANS that has become the state government official program. So Cracker Free Diwali that we started is now backed up by the state government. Then Environment Friendly Ganesha is now backed up by the state government. Environment Friendly Holi is again backed up by the state government. So now whenever we go into schools, we are not telling students which is not into the official state policy. ये सभी state का ही काम है अभी जो करना है वो हम आपको बता रहे हैं. तो I think that is a major success as far as the public movements led by Maharashtra Andhashraddha Nirmuli Samiti are concerned. The third important thing that I want to discuss with all of you is this fear of rationality is not only restricted to superstition eradication and challenging godmen, self-proclaimed godmen. What we have, rationality is required in every sphere of life. And what we have tried to do, and each rationalist movement should aspire to do, is try and expand their scope in different walks of life. And many of the organizations here in Indian Renaissance Society have already done that. I am really happy for that. There is a need for rationality in health. There is a need for rationality in women's rights. There is a need for rationality when we talk about environment. There is need for rationality when we talk about economics, when we talk about administration. So it's across the cross-cutting theme that runs across the everything in a democracy जो हम करते हैं, तो इस तरीके से अपना sphere of influence बढ़ाना, ये मुझे लगता है कि रैशनलिस्ट मूवमेंट के लिए बहुत जरूरी बात है. जैसे अंधश्रद्धा निर्मूलन समिति अभी कास्ट के इशू पे काम करती है, जैसे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल राइट्स के बारे में और रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज के बारे में हम काम करते हैं. तो ये सभी चीज़ें हैं कि हम अपना स्फीयर बढ़ा रहे हैं और वो बढ़ाना बहुत जरूरी है, ऐसा मुझे लगता है. और लास्ट में दो बातें इम्पोर्टेंट रख के मैं अपनी बात खत्म करूँगा. जो शुरू में मैंने बोला था और सर ने भी उसे थोड़ा सा टच किया उस टॉपिक को, आई थिंक वर्किंग फॉर रैशनैलिटी इज नॉट अ डेस्टिनेशन, इट्स अ जर्नी, एंड ऑल ऑफ अस नीड टू रियलाइज दैट इट्स अ एंडलेस जर्नी. वन ऑफ द आर्टिकल्स डॉक्टर दाभोलकर हैज रिटन इन मराठी, इट सेज लाइक एक न संपणारा प्रवास, मीन्स इट्स अ एंडलेस जर्नी, बिकॉज एवरी टाइम यू नीड टू री इन्वेंट वेन यू आर वर्किंग ऑन यूर इरेशनैलिटीज. एंड लाइक वॉट वी हैव इन आवर ब्रेन कैपेसिटी फॉर रैशनल थिंकिंग, वी ऑल्सो हैव ह्यूज पोर्शन ऑफ आवर ब्रेन विच कम्स फ्रॉम एनिमल्स विच इज ओवर पावर्ड बाई इरेशनल डिसीजन मेकिंग. And it's not a static thing, it's a dynamic thing. So if you are rational in your decision making today, that doesn't mean that you will be rational in your decision making tomorrow or under stress. So it's a continuous journey. It's basically a journey of self-inventation, self-reflection. And one should not never forget when they claim that we are rationalist, that it's a journey and it's not a destination. And the last thing I want to mention, which is related to the area of field that I myself work into, I'm a trained mental health professional. I think a path toward rationality cannot bypass the issue of mental health. I'm stating this with utmost responsibility, because the biggest challenge for rationality is how to challenge irrationality. And you can't understand irrationality without knowing human mind. So if we want to expand the scope of human rationality, we don't have a shortcut than studying human mind and from where the irrationalities arise and from where they get collectivized. And that's, I think, a very important lesson all of us need to keep in mind. So I think these were four or five insights I thought that I should just reflect on when we meet. And I'm really happy that you invited us to be with you today, and we'll be really looking forward to develop some relationships and collaborations with you all and learn from each other with a hope that sab hum saath milke we can say with proud ki long live rationality. Thank you.